Hello students, in this lecture we will learn about Taguchi based design of experiments. We know that the experiments are conducted in almost every field to study the performance of processes and systems. A process is governed by the input factors, both controllable as well as uncontrollable, to produce certain response. The controllable input factors can be modified to optimize the output, whereas uncontrollable input factors cannot be changed as per our choice. If you consider the example of cake preparation, the controllable input factors may be oven temperature, quantity of sugar, quantity of flour, quantity of eggs, etc. Whereas the uncontrollable input factor may be moisture level. The response could be the quality of cake in terms of taste and color. The experiments are conducted with objectives as to identify the controllable input factors most influential to the response and to determine their setting so that the variability in the response is small and thereby the effect of uncontrollable input factors are minimized. It means in cake preparation, we have to set the controllable input factors to such a level that whatever may be the variation in the moisture level would hardly affect the quality of cake. The systematic approach of conducting the experiments is known as design of experiments. Design of experiments is thus a branch of applied statistics that deals with planning, conducting, analyzing, and interpreting control tests to identify the most influential controllable input factors and to determine their target levels so that the variability in the response is small and thereby the effect of uncontrollable factors are minimized. This concept of design of experiments, first introduced by Sir R. A. Fisher, is popularly known as factorial design of experiments, which can be full factorial design or fractional factorial design. In full factorial design, we consider all possible combinations for a given set of factors. For example, for abrasive water jet machining process, the effect of five factors: water pressure, diameter of nozzle, nozzle feed rate, mass flow rate of water, and mass flow rate of abrasives is studied on material removal rate. These five factors are considered at three levels, and the values of the factors corresponding to these three levels are shown in this particular table. In this example, the number of levels are three and number of factors are five. So if you go with full factorial design, then total number of experiments required to be conducted are 3 raised to 5, that is 243. However, conducting such a large number of experiments is relatively difficult, time consuming, and costly affair. Hence, to overcome this drawback of full factorial design, we consider fractional factorial design. Fractional factorial design involves carefully chosen subset of experimental runs of full factorial design so as to expose the information about most important features of the problem under study. Taguchi 1980 has proposed a new approach of conducting the design of experiments using a special set of arrays called orthogonal arrays. If you refer back to our problem of abrasive water jet machining process, in which we need to conduct 243 experiments, if you go with Taguchi method, we have to conduct only 18 experiments. Although the number of experiments is drastically reduced from 243 to 18, we could get all information from the 18 experiments, which otherwise could be obtained by conducting 243 experiments. The Taguchi method thus stipulates the way of conducting minimal number of experiments, which could give the full information of all the factors that affect the performance parameters. However, the effectiveness of orthogonal array method lies in choosing the appropriate level combinations of the input design variables for each experiment. Now we will see the steps for implementing the Taguchi experiment design. The first step is to select the dependent and independent variables. The dependent variables must be determined appropriately so as to handle the critical issue of the process under consideration. For example, in abrasive water jet machining process, it is characterized by a low material removal rate. Hence, material removal rate can be considered as a dependent variable for that process. The independent variables should be so chosen that they have a significant effect on the selected dependent variable. Second step is to select the number of label settings for each independent variable. The selection of number of labels depends on how the performance parameter is affected due to different label settings. If the response varies linearly with the input factor, then the optimum response could lie either at minimal value or maximum value of that particular factor. Therefore, the factor is considered only at two levels. However, if the relationship between the response and the input factor is non-linear, for example, say quadratic, then we consider three levels for the input factor. If the relationship is cubic, then we consider four levels of the input factors, and so on. We thus understand that with Taguchi method, we could reduce the number of experiments drastically, and thereby the cost of experimentation is also reduced. However, the exact number of experiments required to be performed by Taguchi method is given by this orthogonal array selector. For example, if we have three levels and five factors, then we choose L18 orthogonal array. It means that we have to conduct 18 experiments. Similarly, if you consider three levels and four factors, then we will select L9 orthogonal array. It means we have to conduct 9 experiments. Properties of an orthogonal array are as mentioned below. The first property is for all columns, all the label setting appears an equal number of times. Thus, if we consider L9 orthogonal array with 4 factors and hence 4 columns and each factor at 3 levels, then every level will appear thrice for every column in these 9 experiments. Similarly, if we consider 18 experiments having 5 factors each at 3 level, then every level will appear 6 times for each column. The second property is all the label values of independent variables are used for conducting the experiment. The third property is the sequence of label values for conducting the experiments shall not be interchanged. It means we cannot exchange the level 2 of experiment 4 with level 1 of experiment 1. Although it follows the property of all labels appearing equal number of times, the design is not valid. Thus, the experiment with label combination 2, 1, 1, 1 or 1, 1, 2, 3 cannot be there in L9 orthogonal array. And the last property is the inner product of vectors corresponding to weight is 0. If we normalize the labels 1 to 3 into labels minus 1 to 1, it means if the label 1 is replaced by minus 1, level 2 replaced by 0 and 3 replaced by 1, then the sum of all labels for every column is 0. The next step is to assign the independent variables to each column. Once the number of experiments are determined, the factor labels are assigned to each column based on the properties of orthogonal array. The next step is conducting the experiments. Once the orthogonal array is selected, the experiments are conducted as per the label combination. It is necessary that all experiments be conducted. The interaction column and dummy variables column shall not be considered for conducting the experiment, but are needed while analyzing the data to understand the interaction effect. The performance parameter under study is noted down for each experiment to conduct the sensitivity analysis. And the last step is analyzing the data and inference. The analysis is carried out to determine the best level combination for maximum performance. However, the performance is evaluated based on the average SN ratio and not based on actual values of response. The SN ratio is a signal to noise ratio. Signal produces desired effects, whereas the noise produces undesired effect. Ultimately, we want to maximize the desired effect and thereby minimize the effect of uncontrollable factors. We have to maximize the SN ratio. The formula to calculate the SN ratio depends upon our goal, that is maximization, minimization or some specific value. So thus, if our goal is to minimize the response, for example, minimization of surface roughness, then we choose smaller the better. And the formula for SN ratio is minus 10 log of 1 upon n summation of I is equal to 1 to n yi square, where y is the value of response and n is the number of times a particular experiment is repeated. Similarly, if the goal is to achieve some specific value, then we choose nominal the better, and the formula of SN ratio is 10 log of mu square upon sigma square, where mu square is the square of mean and sigma square is variance. If our goal is to maximize the response, for example, maximization of material removal rate, then we choose larger the better, and the SN ratio is calculated as minus 10 log of 1 by n summation of I is equal to 1 to n 1 upon yi square. Now, to demonstrate the effectiveness of Taguchi method, let us consider a case study of laser surface treatment of aluminum alloy. Because the lasers can transfer the high energy precisely to the desired region, they are preferred in many surface treatment applications. So, the first step of Taguchi method is to identify the dependent variable and independent variable. So, in case of pulse laser, the risk of hot cracking is high, especially while machining this aluminum alloy, since they have temperature cycles with high cooling rates. And therefore, hot cracking is a critical issue in case of laser surface treatment. And therefore, crack length is considered as a dependent variable in this particular case study. The four factors identified are focus position, pulse energy, gas type, and pulse duration, supposed to have a significant effect on this crack length. These four factors are considered at three levels each. The values of these factors at each level are shown in this particular table. So, thus focus position is plus 1 mm at level 1, it is plus 2 mm at level 2 and plus 3 mm at level 3. The pulse energy is 10 joules at level 1, 15 joules at level 2 and 20 joules at level 3. Three types of gases are used: the oxygen at level 1, nitrogen at level 2 and air at level 3. And the pulse duration is 3 microseconds at level 1, 5 microseconds at level 2 and 10 microseconds at level 3. Now, the next step is to decide the orthogonal array. Since in this particular case, we have four factors at three levels each, and therefore, from the orthogonal array selector, we can select L9 orthogonal array. So, we have to perform 9 experiments as per this orthogonal array, and the level combinations for all the experiment is as shown in this particular chart. The first experiment is conducted at level 1 for all the factors. It means the actual combination, actual values are plus 1 mm for the focus position, 10 joule for pulse energy, gas type is oxygen, and pulse duration is 3 microseconds. Now, by selecting this set of the parameters, we perform the experiments and the value of crack length is recorded. So, for the first experiment, the crack length value is 805.9 micrometer per mm square. Similarly, the crack length is evaluated for all other experiments. Then we calculate the SN ratio. Now, in this particular case, our objective is to minimize the crack length. So, here we are minimizing the response, and hence we choose smaller the better. The formula for SN ratio for smaller the better is minus 10 log to the base 10 of square of the response. So, we take the response value as 805.9, and the value of SN ratio corresponding to this crack length of 805.9 is minus 58.125. Similarly, the SN ratios for all other experiments are calculated. Then, next step is analysis and inference. So, in this we calculate the average SN ratio at all levels of each factor. So, thus if we consider this level 1 of focus position, then the average ascent ratio will be calculated by considering all 1 levels and its ascent ratio. So thus we consider this ascent ratio for level 1 of this focus position, similarly second ascent ratio and the third. So we consider these 3 ascent ratios and we take average. So the average ascent ratio is -57.81 for this level 1 of focus position. Similarly, if we want to compute the average ascent ratio at level 2 for the factor pulse energy, then we consider all level 2 values in the pulse energy and we take corresponding ascent ratios. So here we take this ascent ratio, then this ascent ratio and this ascent ratio, and then we take the average of these 3 ascent ratios, which is coming out as -53.18. Similarly, all other values of average ascent ratios are calculated. Now, since our objective is to maximize the ascent ratio, we will select that level for a particular factor for which the average ascent ratio is maximum. So thus, for the first factor, focus position, the ascent ratio is maximum at level 2, which is -55.63. Similarly, for pulse energy, the ascent ratio is maximum at level 2. For gas type, the average ascent ratio is maximum at level 1. And for pulse duration, the ascent ratio is maximum at level 3. Thus, the optimum level combination here is 2, 2, 1, 3. And the corresponding actual values of that particular factors are +2 mm for focus position, then 15 joule for pulse energy, then gas type oxygen, and 10 microsecond for pulse duration. Now, it should be noted that this experiment 2213 is not available in this L9 orthogonal array. It means this experiment is actually, this experiment or this level combination is actually achieved from all possible combinations. In this particular case, all possible combinations would be 3^4 is equal to 81. So thus we can see that this level combination is obtained not from these 9 experiments, but from all possible 81 combinations. The next task is to decide the significance or the influence of that particular factor on the response. The significance of the factor can be determined by considering the difference between the maximum average ascent ratio and minimum average ascent ratio for a particular factor. Thus, for focus position, the maximum ascent ratio is -55.63 and minimum ascent ratio is -50.09. So the difference is 2.46. Similarly, this difference is calculated for all factors. Now, the factor with highest difference, for example, this gas type is having the maximum difference value, is considered as the most significant factor. So thus, if we rank these factors according to their significance, then gas type is most significant, followed by the pulse energy, then pulse duration, and focus position is the least significant factor. So in this manner, this particular Taguchi method can be used to determine the optimum combination of this particular level so that the ascent ratio is maximum and thereby the effect of uncontrollable factors is minimum. Similarly, we can also find out the most significant factor and least significant factor using this particular method. Now you can apply the steps of Taguchi method to maximize the material removal rate in case of electric discharge machining process. The 3 independent variables are pulse current, pulse on time, and pulse off time. And these factors are considered at 3 levels each. Therefore, L9 orthogonal array is selected, and the data for 9 experiments is as shown in this table. Your task is to determine the optimum factor level combination for maximum material removal rate using the Taguchi method, and also to determine the most significant and least significant factors. You can refer these books as well as the journal article for further reading. So, thank you.